So my science is basic science. And what that means is that I'm finding out how something works at a very fundamental level, you know, the physiology of it, the morphology of it, the mechanics of it, whether it ends up at some point in time helping to solve a problem, we don't know. Maybe, maybe not. But what it does is that it contributes to this base of knowledge that we have, without which we would not be able to solve problems at all. Okay, so science is not a linear process. It's not that if I want to cure cancer, you know, the easiest way is to start from A to B to Z. It doesn't work that way. You need to have people who are having a very broad base, you know, people who are coming at it from different ways, asking different questions, and then somebody else comes in and they make an unexpected connection. And as you build on that, eventually, you know, somebody comes up and they're like, oh yeah, this therapy that they're using for something totally unrelatable might be the key to study this question. And that's just how it goes. And so without that broad base of knowledge, the tip of the iceberg, which is the finding those applications, would just simply go away. And so we can't pick and choose from the beginning and say, well, we're only going to study things that we know are going to have some benefit. Because we don't know. We don't know what we don't know. That's the whole point. It's the whole point of science. And in the meantime, we're pushing the boundaries of our knowledge and just figuring out, okay, so then how do things work, you know? And that's important. It's an important part of what makes us human, I think.